The search for life beyond Earth. We have always been fascinated by the thought of any life elsewhere in the universe. The idea has provided the basis for a huge wealth of science fiction stories that have been limited only by our imagination. But can other creatures exist in the vast reaches of space or other planets or moons? And are there other intelligent forms of life out there? Is there life beyond Earth? Where are all the aliens? These are the questions that has been asked for years, and scientists too have been working towards finding an answer to this question. But now scientists are moving towards finding a definite answer to this question. Our sun is just one star among billions in our galaxy. In the last few years, scientists have detected thousands of planets around the other stars, and it seems that most stars have planetary system. It's therefore likely that there will be large number of habitable planets in the Milky Way galaxy, and beyond that are capable of supporting intelligent life. Some of these intelligent civilizations, if they are out there, may have been developed interstellar travel. But Earth has not been visited by any intelligent aliens yet. This apparent high probability of life, combined with a lack of evidence for its existence, is called the Fermi paradox, named for the physicist Enrico Fermi, who first outlined the argument back in 1950. This begs the question, where is everybody? Back in 1961, astronomer Francis Drake tried to rationalize a question by developing an equation that takes into account all the factors relevant to finding alien civilization and gives an estimate of the number of civilizations out there in the galaxy that should be able to communicate with us. It considers factors such as the rate of new star formation, how many planets around those new and existing stars might be able to support life, the number of planets supporting intelligent life, how many of those civilizations might have technology we can detect, whether they are likely to communicate with us here on Earth, and so on. More than 4,000 exoplanets, planets around other stars, have been confirmed to exist in our galaxy, but likely number in the trillions. One of the best tools scientists have to begin narrowing the search for habitable worlds is a concept known as the habitable zone. It's the orbital distance from a star where temperature would potentially allow liquid water to form on planet's surface. Many other conditions also would be required. A planet of suitable size with a suitable atmosphere and a stable star not too prone to erupting in sterilizing flares. The habitable zone is really just a way to make the first cut and zero in on the planets with the best chance of processing habitable condition. Scientists and radio astronomers have started the search for extraterrestrial intelligence, also called SETI, in a systematic manner. Several international organizations, including the SETI Institute and the SETI League, are using radio telescope to detect signal that might have been produced by intelligent life. In 1995, the SETI Institute started Project Phoenix, which used three of the most powerful radio telescopes in the world: the Green Bank Radio Telescope in the West Virginia, USA, the Arecibo Telescope in Puerto Rico, and the Parkes Radio Telescope in NSW, Australia. During its initial phase, Project Phoenix used the Parkes Telescope to search for signal coming from 202 sun-like stars at a distance as 155 light-years away. By the end of its operation, Project Phoenix had scanned a total 800 nearby stars for signs of life. The project detected some cosmic noise, but none that could be attributed to aliens. While there is currently excitement about sending human crews to Mars, missions beyond the red planet are at this stage pretty much not feasible. The distance and travel times involved are simply too great. Basically, all exploration for life beyond Earth will need to be done using robotic space probes and landing rovers. These instruments can provide a huge wealth of information and are capable of exploring as far away as Pluto, perhaps even beyond our solar system. But as for life beyond the solar system, the nearest stars are several light years away, and even communication by electromagnetic waves, which all travel at the speed of light, are essentially going to be one-way messages. While we probably won't find intelligent life too close to home, there is a chance we may still find much simpler life form. Do we have neighbors beyond Earth? Time will tell, and the search continues. So I hope you learned something in this video. If you have any questions, please type in comment section and share with your friends and family to support me. So see you again in next video. For then, bye bye.